Hi there, and welcome to Searching Scopus. Scopus is a very large database that covers science, technology, medicine, social sciences, as well as the arts and humanities. Today, we're going to be using Scopus to find articles for our research topic, which is what methods or strategies are effective in assisting Indigenous Australians quit smoking. To begin with, we can type our keywords into this search box. This form gives us the option to use multiple key terms in each search, but we want to avoid that because it's not as flexible as searching for each concept or key term individually. Our first concept is smoking and how to quit. Now, I know from previous searches that I've done in Medline and Sinal that one way of describing the concept is smoking cessation. So I'll put that in this box. Note that I'm putting the term in quotation marks. These force Scopus to look for the two words exactly as they are. Without these quotation marks, Scopus will look for either of the two words, and it could really mess me around. Once I've entered my keywords, I can either press the return key or hit the search button here. And there are our results. I could do a search within these results for other terms, but that will really limit my flexibility to play around with these other concepts at a later stage. So I'm going to ignore these results for now, but we will come back to them in a couple of minutes. Let's go back to our main search form by clicking the search button in the top left of the screen here. I'll just clear that. And before we type in our second concept, just have a look down here. This is our search history, and we're going to use this in a minute to combine our key concepts. So let's put our concept for Indigenous Australians in. Now, we could just type Indigenous Australians, and that would probably get us some results, but there are other words that we could use. I want to just focus on searching for anything to do with Indigenous people. So what I've got here in my notepad document is every synonym that I could think of to describe Indigenous Australians or Torres Strait Islanders. So I have Indigenous or Torres or Australoid, which is an old term but still does get used, or Aborigine with an asterisk, which we'll find Aborigine, Aboriginal, Aborigines with an S, Aboriginals with an S, Aboriginality, or Oceanic Ancestry Group. I know from my search in Medline that Oceanic Ancestry Group is the mesh term used in the US to describe people who have ancestral origins in the Pacific Islands, which includes Australia. So having typed that out in Notepad, I can just copy and paste that over into there. So I'll hit search. And there are our results. Now, some of these articles might talk about Indigenous Australians or Torres Strait Islanders, but because Scopus is a very large international database, a lot of these articles will also talk about Indigenous peoples in North America, the Pacific Islands, or Southeast Asia. We need to specify which region we want to focus on. So we're going to go back to our main search form and put in our location details. Clearing that. Now, you would have seen when I went to Notepad before that I've got this big block of text here. These are my keywords for Australia. So I have Austral with an asterisk, which we'll find Australia or Australian, along with every single state and territory within Australia in its full name, as well as its initializations. Remember, we're trying to keep the search nice and broad at this point, so we need to give Scopus the broadest possible terms to look for. We'll narrow our search down after this. So copy and paste that into the search document and hit search. And there are our results for the Australia concept. Now we're going to go back to our search screen and we're going to combine these with the word and. And as an operator is a narrowing term. It finds the overlap between our concepts. In other databases, there are boxes you can check. Unfortunately, in Scopus, those don't exist. You have to manually type out which searches you'd like to combine. So we have an example here, e.g. #1 and not #3. So that's how you structure it. So we need to do #1 and #2 and #3. And that brings us down to 118 documents, which is a really good search. Most of these will be quite useful to us. But what we want to do is limit it down even further. So let's only choose the last 5 years. Over on the left-hand side here, I've got my limits that I can apply. I can see 2014 through to 2010, but I'd also like some articles from 2009. So I need to click View More, and that will get me those. Then I hit Limit 2. And that brings my 118 down to 77. I can also apply my document types, my subject areas, or if I'm looking for a specific author that I know is prolific or speaks about what I want to learn about, I can narrow down by there. I can also choose different keywords that have been applied. And if you keep clicking View More, it pops out into a huge box there that has all the keywords across all of these results. I'm not too interested in doing that at the moment. I can also change my language. All of these are in English because they're all Australian articles. What I might do is I will limit it down to Review, which will obviously give me 8 articles. And these are probably going to be very useful to me. Over on the right-hand side, in this column here, we have our cited by. Each of these articles, with the exception of this one, has been cited in other research that has also been indexed by Scopus. I can sort this to get the most cited articles at the top by clicking Cited By. This shows that this 2011 article, Smoking Cessation in Indigenous Populations of Australia, New Zealand, Canada and the United States, Elements of Effective Interventions, has been cited 10 times since it was published. If I want to look at that article, I can just click on the title. That will give me the abstract, and it will also give me mesh terms that I can use in other searches. So I did a search for smoking cessation. I could have also done a search for smoking cessation program or nicotine replacement therapy. If I want to download the full text of this, I just need to click on this Find It at JCU button. We have another video that will show you how to use that button and what to do if it doesn't work. Going back to our results, the last thing I'd like to show you today is how to export these to a bibliographic management tool like EndNote. All you have to do is check the boxes of the articles that you would like and then hit the Export button. Choose RIS format for EndNote and then choose All Available Information, which will give you as much information as possible to download into EndNote, and then hit Export. Don't forget that if you get stuck, you can always talk to the friendly staff over at InfoHelp, either in person or via email, phone, chat, or Facebook. We're here to help you. Thanks for watching.